begin.
As I was talking over the intro. That's okay. He probably told him to chill out or something. Gets the offense going. Gunshots from full screen into the lasers. And Sonic using every second of recovery to trade up that gun as he's desperately trying to get to level two. And this is so clean from Fox. Taking Chip. But the game honestly changes once Fox's Colt gets two bars into his trait, because he keeps it pretty much for the rest of the game. The way that he uses the character, and he's able to reset and get another two bars off of the first initial snow globe.
And Theo not caring about any of this. Sonic is going to go into his snow globe, and he can't just charge his gun for free as Superman has those lasers to interrupt. Now, there you go, the heat zap.
So much chip damage.
As he has the ice puddle right in front, Sonic going to go for the...
Oh, I know it's gone by then, but he is going to get it confirmed. He's going to spend it, and I think that was worth it. Charging it for the second trade instead of going straight for the damage.
I don't know what Theo was looking for in this situation, but the back dash there after getting hit by the wall, able to escape.
Nice meter burn roll through.
Yeah, but Captain Cold, not much in the meterless damage department.
No, not at all, actually. His meterless damage is very weak.
Design this gun myself.
Mid-screen.
Absolutely. Another thing about that Captain Cold trait gun, as it reaches different levels, his trait shot, his backboard worn normal projectile does in fact travel faster with each level do more damage.
Yes.
Cold front coming.
And at level two, it is a serious projectile.
There's the clash from Theo now jumping back just out of the range to not trade with Cold's projectiles. Lasers up. Here's the trade. Oppression session starting from Theo.
And he tried for the down one, but Theo slightly backed up for, like, just for a split second, and the spacing was immaculate.
All right, Sonic Fox with that level two, playing the projectile game. Here's the meter burn roll.
Getting caught. Not a lot of damage. Superman, though, with two bars. And now the life lead is in Theo's favor.
Extremely patient play from Theo. Here's the throw right there. Not going for the much. Mix up heavy potential up close, and his trait finally returns. And no clash from Sonic Fox. This is going to be...
Is he really not going to clash here?
He is not. Trait lasers, any chip damage situation would put Sonic in big time trouble.
And Sonic doesn't even have his trait anymore, and there is the clash, but...
How long are you keeping
with
on
one
ice?
Bar, Theo can...
It's not what I had planned.
...potentially continue the bleeding here, but he's not going to spend it.
And that clash is going to retract the trait buildup from Cold back down to nothing. Gonna have to get in the old-fashioned way with the combo as Theo is chipping away at his life piece by piece. Punish! Oh,
okay, a little bit of damage here. Down one under the dash punch.
And this could be it! The meter burn, here's the back three. Does he have enough juggle left?
And he does! Wow! So, for a late clash, which we doubted. Or at least I did. I'm not gonna put you in that boat too, but...
All right, Sonic Fox now waking up, not playing with Theo at all until he has level 2 trait ready at the helm. That Death Sickle looking for a better trade to deal with Theo's lasers and maneuverability. And look at the speed on these projectiles. And the down one into the level 2. Theo in big time trouble. Now here's the throw. He's going to get frozen from this. Absolutely run up. Full combo now from Sonic Fox.
Oh, and let me tell you something. Although he doesn't do a lot of damage meterless, Cold is a character that will dish out some hurt, as long as he has at least trait or bar or both.
Well, talking about hurt, here's Theo with the raw jump in coming from Superman into the restanding possibility. Sonic watching his legs and
very
puts
nice
up the wall.
I've wasted enough time.
Nice down two, one of, if not the best in the game.
Here's the corner set up, the icicle, and the meter burn, bro.
So dirty!
The overhead cross up Theo, not ready for the attempt. Has the clash immediately, but luckily, in his defense, he has the life lead, the meter lead, and now he has Sonic in the corner right where he wants him.
But Sonic has shown that he can fight it. Wow, just two straight lasers.
All right, trading up now. Saving the recovery. We'll put the faith in his defense. Challenges the throw with the jump in.
Beautiful with punish.
To the corner. Here's the full almost charge. Corner extension. Icicle setup. Low overhead. Low.
Whoa.
All within two frames of each other. And I don't know if it's two frames, but that's what it feels like watching this level two tree. Here's the wake up. Baited now. Theo in big time trouble.
That is going to be it. So, wow. 2-0. Cold player versus Superman.
Did you think you would see Captain Cold at all?
No, actually I didn't, and I'm so excited to
see
this character.
That's the beauty of this game early. People get so strung up and complaining about popular characters, forgetting that balance is in fact a thing, and Cold here in utility putting in the work against Superman. This is not some improbable situation. People just need to open their eyes.
Now a lot of eyes are being opened right now by Sonic Fox. There is the trade.
Right into the death globe. It's Theo in big time trouble. Back to the wall and a slowdown cross up here. Sonic Fox rolling here in this third game.
Somebody call the ice cream man?
Pushing up. He's already got a bar. Working on the second bar here. Fighting from the corner with no qualms. That down two is so good. It extends his hitbox, but not his hurtbox.
Every approach has been denied. Captain Cold with that down two, able to cover the air, not worried about jump ins or air dashes, and that wall at the perfect distance, closing all of the gaps. Oh, here we go again. Push blocks this time. Theo's still stuck in the globe. How's he going to escape?
And he's just desperately trying to run out of there. He does find his way out.
Successfully, that's how. Theo with the great reads. Now the back dash, catching Sonic, charging it up.
He did pay with quite a bit of his life, though, when he was trying to get out of that snow globe of death.
Oh, and there's the protection right there in front. That ice puddle. Theo will have to jump over an air dash to escape. Gets the level two out, and Theo was in trouble. This
combo.
Juggle is going to freeze. Inevitable.
Oh, and what a punish!
And just like that, a shot to the S on his chest. On the other side of winners, Dragon against White Boy.
Here we go.
Patience. Air-to-air jump attack, and Dragon draws first, stretching out that lightning bolt on the chest. Some fantastic fabric from the people in Egypt. I don't know how that costume doesn't rip, but Black Adam is definitely in there.
The Tailors of Combat give a shout out here. But this is a really interesting matchup because I think Scarecrow overall does really well against Adam. Once he puts him on the ground, it's really tough for Adam to get anything going.
And after that,
especially without a true, really good wake up.
And oppressing is Dragon, using that down one to have his way. Dragon has no idea what to do in this situation after blocking plus six, trying to jump out, but White Boy having none of it.
Oh, I was going to say that could have been a very costly drop, but unfortunately he actually threw him out of the corner, which gives Dragon a little bit of leeway. Still great first round from White Boy.
Where he challenges the plus frames on the EX dive kick, looking for that forward one, which in NRS games, high attacks will not hit you crouching. Thus, you'll see players at high level poking under them all the time.
Yeah.
On read, on reaction. That's exactly what White Boy did there. Dragon turned the tide back in his favor, depleting that first life bar, putting them on even grounds.
Early box for it. Okay, 1-1. Cancel. That's a really awkward string to deal with after the cancel. It catches people off guard all the time because you're always expecting the third hit.
Walking back now, extremely patient. That empty jump from Dragon, from White Boy. Excuse me, I'm mixing them up. Why am I mixing them up?
It's okay. They're both young and they're both talented.
Yes.
Nice. Again, going straight into the command grab. And he actually gets the wake up. Dragon is not afraid to use it.
Sometimes you got to go for it. Super ambiguous. White Boy with the back dash to clear the space.
And there it is, though. White Boy is going to take the begin.
All right. They start out the same way again with patience. Dragon looking for the trait cancel into the throw, but White Boy still in the hit stun.
Yeah, and we saw just there, Dragon using that forward one. One of the best anti-airs in the game. Black Adam's forward one is so strong.
All right, rearranging all of the furniture here in the throne room in Atlantis. Black Adam only believes in himself as a king, but Scarecrow cares about none of that.
No. In fact, he loves showing the kings around the world of their fear.
All right, down one chain, looking for the mix-up with the sickle. Expecting Dragon to recommand grab, but is a very patient man. Recovers after that wake up, able to get the down one, but no continuation.
Yep. And that string, actually, it is plus, but you can backdash the last hit.
Well, no backdash in this situation. As Dragon carries White Boy towards the corner of death, looking for the chip. Anything will do
it. And he tried for the instant air blast.
Yeah, it was pretty cute from White Boy suspending himself in the air, looking for the lightning, but instead it was a patient dive kick. And Dragon now, the tape on replay, this offense nonstop. White Boy not able to get anything going in the second game.
The back three now raw into the chain. Patience from both players. I really like when these games kind of boil down to this play lead.
Yeah, Jazz up command grab. That is the riskiest, but big time reads. And the big boost to the back. Okay, tap the toes a few more times. He wants to make sure he gets his workout in. Scarecrow trying to stay as agile as possible.
And Arachnid coming to his face, though. No agility there. Armor back three again. Problem with that, I know what he's trying to do, but that is a very, not very slow, but it is one of the slower back threes. It's not exactly the quickest.
Oh, there's the unclashable forward threes from Dragon, the meaty meter burn, low lightning, looking for max damage, White Boy in chip territory.
Wow. And look at that Dragon
change of scenery. Let's see if these guys open up with the extreme patience like the first two games. No way, White Boy immediately challenging down two into that fear blast. Everything rolling now, White Boy working on a perfect. He is halfway there. White Dragon looking for the wake up. White Boy having none of it.
Yeah, not going to work this time. Jump in and more pressure plus frames. Nice. Oh, good.
And there's the plus frames pummeling the young man from Delaware. Is White Boy oppressing himself, having his way. No chip damage there, but no punish.
Wow, and literally the only thing that stopped that from being a flawless life bar was the trait from Adam. And that is going to catch.
Yeah, Dragon in big time trouble here. Has to clash immediately. That was going to be around 400 damage into mediocre setups. One bar, of course, you know, slightly more than 15% lost. And the trait is activated now. Damage over time, as long as White Boy can get close. Every bit of chip helps.
Wow. Down one, command grab. We haven't seen I really love the way that White Boy spreads those out. Doesn't use them all at once, and he really makes his opponent think about it. What a confirm.
Unbelievable here from White Boy. This is all put over. Nice punish there, but I don't even think a real master could come back from this.
I mean, it's going to be hard. He's going to take this life bar at the very least.
And here's a big-time problem, full screen.
So this is Adam, right? One of the best closers in the game. Guess what? Meet Scarecrow, also one of the best closers in the game, both with trait.
And punished there. Here's the teleport. This is death accepted. Dragon knows a thing or two about it. He actually tweeted that if you have low life and Scarecrow activates trait, begin. We got you fine. A background bounce in place, and this time more aggression as both players jump towards each other. White Boy.
What a start. 455 damage, KP. Oh, and this, wow, this is so dominating for White Boy.
Let's stretch it out, baby, as we get those legs up. Everybody with me now. Scarecrow trying to get the job done. But Dragon, pretty ambiguous, hits on the front side into the corner. What's it going to be? Wake up, of course. White Boy wants nothing to do with it. Patience. And the dive kick. Chasing him down the jump back and White Boy now.
That was so sick. That was so sick.
One health bar away from winner's finals. Dragon, what does he have? What does he have left in the tank? And another air-to-air. White Boy with the life lead in this situation. Not the best position for Dragon to try and clash. Takes out the trash on him.
Okay, that actually could have been a big confirm. That was a huge chance for Dragon. Still has Scarecrow stuck in the corner, and that is going to do it.
Yeah, White Boy caught trying to disrespect, paid for it with his first life bar. Now in the corner, meter burn back three, whiffs it, and Dragon's patience slowly allowing him to crawl back into this.
The meter drop, though.
And there is the punish. Whiff it once, shame on me. Whiff it twice, no way, says Dragon. He gets the full combo conversion back into the corner. A little late on the back dash, eats that unblockable damage from that car, and Dragon is very much in this now. White Boy, desperation, throwing out normals, and another whiff, and Dragon with another punish.
Yep, and now that's going to be three bars available for, excuse me, White Boy to clash. He's going to spend two, getting 25%. White Boy's actually been caught by a lot of dive kicks. Trying to walk up and duck, and again that ambiguous neutral jump too.
And this time, the meter unnecessary with the background bounce helping anything. There's the trait summit.
Oh, huge! This is huge. Hit.
One read and the jump back air to air one. Dragon trying to keep his winner's life alive. Close enough. There's the trait once more.
This is so tense. A block. Wait, he gets hit. And
oh,
the
jump back one.
Jump back one. Mass
Dragon does also play Adam.
Locked in now. The final game. 2-2. Doubles Dragon. Renegades is White Boy. And great whip punish there. White Boy getting a little antsy. That Dolphin dive from a little too far out. But then Dragon right back at it. Going for that meter burn. Excuse me, the wake up Lightning Cage.
And all this pressure again. This is all plus. Look at the beautiful top hat.
And that is a punish on the command grab with that instant jump attack. Fantastic read from Dragon.
Double down one into Lightning Hands for the Palpatines. Plus frames, good push block.
A bar that's, for a bar.
Yeah, and that's been Dragon's adaptation for the most part. He's been... Oh, my God. As I was saying, that's been Dragon's adaptation for the most part. He's been push blocking as soon as he's seen White Boy burning meter for the plus frames.
Going for that meaty back three. Probably looking for the back dash on wake up. Either way, he's going to eat... The fruit of this entire 400 plus damage is Dragon.
Oh, and that is gonna hit one bar apiece.
Why is this the inevitable? This is nowhere yet.
Huge shock of lightning. Get out of my face. Oh, and poor Steve.
Oh, no, Steve, what?
Just look at him. Look at that man. He took something out of his chest. I need the tech. Give me the replay on that. If this is how he gets a second chance at life, I don't know. But right now, Scarecrow putting in the work, the command grab, stretching out Black Adam.
Oh, and he just a dash up, so disrespectful.
That's right. Welcome to the Gotham Gym.
And another one. This is now where he's so threatening. He's doing things that he hasn't done before.
And again, White Boy.
And that is it. White Boy will move on to the... I shouldn't have spoke. I spoke at the very end. What is it in this matchup, though, that is so good for Harley that helps her?
Well, Harley's very annoying with Batman, and she keeps him out. Batman wants to be up close and deal with all this pressure. She can contend his Batarang zoning with the gunshots. She has the overhead gunshots, the hyenas,
right.
The meteor burn cupcakes. Just so many tools in the arsenal to annoy Batman. However, King, in the corner, you have nowhere
King
to run.
He doesn't seem to care about literally anything you just said.
Of course, impose your will and not allow Harley the space to do whatever she loves to do, which is annoy you.
Yeah.
And force you to break down, which is a universal trait in all fighting games.
She just happens to do it really well. Okay, so again, patience, but this is a large life lead.
Yeah, Batman simply can't just run his way in as he wants to. Biohazard keeping King right where he wants him right now. He's in a massive life deficit, but it all adds up piece by piece as he meter burns the overhead gunshots, and King trying to follow. He was going to jump right.
He was chasing right back.
And Biohazard with the errant jump. Great read from Forever King.
How'd you think this would go?
Trades are out. Very plus. Has to deal with these hyenas. And not able to get the activation on the second hyena call. Forever King with that meter burn roll. And now Batman is in. Pressure time.
Pressure time indeed, KP. All of this pressure. And now getting opened up is Biohazard. A lot of damage. 452.
And there's the whiff punish here from Biohazard. Full combo. Big mallet for the back three. A lot of chip in that situation, King.
Yeah, that actually was quite a bit.
In between the Batarangs, good zoning from Biohazard.
Oh,
and again,
that was beautiful.
King rolling in, using the security blanket that is the mechanical bat, having no problem expending his meter for traversal of the stage instead of Batarang pressure.
Oh, nice duck. He is going to backdash out of the way of that bear trap, and it is going to snap without any Batmans in it.
Double jump to evade everything. Meter burns it to evade the gunshot, but gets hit upon landing. Now, Biohazard, although a massive life deficit, any touch is going to kill.
He's been bringing it back, though.
Yes. There's the cupcake bomb, the free chip after Forever King blocks the hyenas.
Oh, nice evasion. But that is it. Gets hit with a back one.
Didn't play it terribly bad. Just put himself in a big hole early, and it was kind of hard to come back from that situation.
You're absolutely right. He got in a little too deep too early.
And there's the down one challenge after into the tantrum stance. Now here's the corner setup. Hyena is called the overhead version. King with a wake up down two to avoid any neutral jump mix-ups.
Oh, and still using the mechanical bat after the block to keep technically the plus frames from the bear trap to be nullified.
Yes, and Biohazard looking to challenge. After you block Batman's trait, they have no block stun. So you can press a button immediately right after, but if the Batman player is right on point with his normals following up, then you can get hit as we saw Biohazard get his down two interrupted.
And beautiful landing with recovery punish.
And again, Biohazard looking for the whiff punish there in between that headbutt and those double knees, but a little too late to the party as Batman strikes first and Trevor King takes the life bar.
Okay. Still, this is kind of the same situation as we've seen, or as we saw last round. Bio, though, not as in bad shape this time as he was last time. Oh, and just running right in, following the mechanical mat, hitting the low, but Biohazard should be able to close it out, and he does.
There you go, back to back, and this time not facing a massive life deficit as he goes into the red health. Chip galore, there's a straight gunshot. Again, Forever King making great usage of that bat straight into the meter burn roll to force his way in as Biohazard has kept him out otherwise. Goes for the full tension stance one.
And whiffing that, I think he was expecting Forever King to jump and meet him in the air with that normal as he went instantly, but he landed and got punished for it.
Gunshots galore. Overhead gunshots. Delay on the meter burn. Rids Batman of the trait. Exactly what Biohazard wants. And King looking for the read, but Biohazard not biting. Finally jumps in. There's a whiff. And
ooh,
the instant
wow
jump too. So much hit stun. Enough for Batman to land.
Land. He can go. He can hit you on the way up, then land, then still combo you.
And this is going to be it. No, it is not. The meter burn. Two bars for the air escape. Is Biohazard whipping some buttons, and King is now in.
King is going to close out the second game. Begin.
All right, dashes in. Follows up immediately now. An infinitely more aggressive play. Biohazard right now, and King reverting to his zoning tendencies that have done him so well in this tournament so far.
I got to say, wow.
And the meter burn roll followed up by the command grab, chasing down the backdash, but King going for two backdashes. And Biohazard, even in debuff, fighting like the warrior spirit that he has. Piece by piece, slowing it down, trying to evade, spinning the meter to get in.
Yeah, the problem is he's actually spending too much meter, and he's not going to be able to really utilize it for damage. It's just, it's all going to just get in.
Oh, looking for the air grab, a little preemptive on the read is Biohazard. King able to land and get the punish on the whiff recovery from that bait.
Just out of range, going for the grab. Burning another bar of venom.
All right, it completes the string, gets the kick, jumps in, and King push blocks immediately, afraid of the mix-ups up close. Smart stuff to not deal with them at all.
Beautiful with punish there with the mechanical bat. This is it. This is Biohazard's last leg.
And there's the unsafe slide. Biohazard couldn't punish it, but instead gets the command grab. King with the wake-up jump.
Oh, nice block from Biohazard going right under, and he's going to catch. Oh, okay.
And that OTG'd off the ground.
That was
a continued
so
combo.
Sick.
OTG 640. I definitely kept the eye out for that one. Here's the Bane charge to get right back in there. Another one back-to-back. Will the grapple connect? Yes.
Nice punish from King. Immediate break, two bars available for Biohazard. But also two for King. He's gonna bet one.
Time to get in, but didn't want to risk.
It's a
terrible movement
yeah
and debuff. The forward dash, everything slowed down for Bane.
That is why Biohazard is the best with this character.
Yeah, venom management so important.
Okay.
And the call out from Biohazard, the challenge, raw command grab from max range.
That trait is going to charge up so fast because it was just the first level. And here we go. This could be where it all starts for Biohazard. Can he make it happen? No, rolls out, but
come.
He chases it down. Where are you going, Bruce?
Spins the bar meter to put him back in the corner now. Batman with the wake-up jump. Biohazard looking for that uppercut. Big read.
Oh,
and that's
no
so costly. Two bars on the air escape. Blocks the jump too successfully now as King is trying to force his way in while he's on debuff and commits to the slide. one mix-up away, and there's a crossover jump. Completing this combo will eliminate Biohazard.
Do it. Wow. Biohazard falls 3-0.
And so close. Research to find everything he could on Yamini as we go back to the
assignment. There's not a lot, trust me.
Tries to slide his way in. The instant jump three from Yamini right in front. And Foxy, again, characteristically push blocking everyone out of his zone.
This is actually really what a call out.
Six frame right in between it. Foxy will not deal with the Hurricane Bow.
What I was going to say, this is a very interesting matchup because this is not a matchup in which Deadshot can do quick shots, really. He has to do either the trick shots or the low gun.
And Yamini being patient, the knockdown from the Fire Arrow, Foxy with the wake-up trait, looking for those knockback bullets. And it's funny because Deadshot usually looks to mix you up to put the right bullet for the occasion. However, with Green Arrow, knowing that the low arrow go under everything.
Oh, just three slides, meter burn back-to-back.
Yeah, that was kind of ridiculous. Forget the strategy. Just do slide meter burn every single time. It is what it is. And Foxy fighting fire with fire, planting the bomb on the chair and going for the corner combos.
1% arrows. These trades are not in his favor, but he does end up using the meter burn roll in with a down one into the Hurricane Bow.
Yamini loads up a nice arrow looking for a trade at this point. Meter burn rolls in, jumps over, keeps it low, challenges down one.
Oh, and he's going to get hit. Only 73 damage, not the worst. Oh, and there's a freeze.
Yeah, Foxy runs right into that to the corner we go where Green Arrow has insane mix-up
potential.
Nice
meter burn.
426 damage stays in the front, and Foxy forced the clash right now. Yamini mixing with the greatest of ease.
What an incredible sequence coming out of Yamini. All it took for him was just to get in once.
And there's the knockback from Foxy jumping in, looking for the re-grid spacing, and Foxy a little too early on the challenge. Meter burn, low rifle, no bar for Foxy. The throw.
Nice grab.
Yamini now in there.
That's probably my favorite grab in the game, I think.
And the wake up right back at you from Foxy looking to mix. Now both guys playing the offensive game and the clash from Yamini.
One bar for Yamini, so he is going to spend it. He's going to get 15% back, but it is going to send both of these characters to full screen.
15% arrow back. Foxy traits up. Yamini loads his arrows back to back, looking for the challenge, but again, too far that time. Interrupts it. That one into the arrow. Great blocks.
So much stagger on those electric arrows.
Wow.
It gets in.
Goes for
just
it.
A
now.
Little bit left.
And the jump in from Foxy blocks successfully. There's the overhead. Doesn't commit now. And the meter burn, low rifle, enough chip. Will Yamini get an arrow out?
Oh, what a
he
trick!
Does. Yep. To get that shot off before the second meter burn bullet would have killed him. What a clutch situation.
Again with the interrupt, Yamini so brave, going with the 4-3 instead. He's going to have Deadshot in the corner now. And this is the most dangerous thing, I think, about Green Arrow, is once he gets the momentum, he is a powerhouse.
Well, here we go, Foxy waking up to short some of that momentum and get back into the neutral game that he loves to play himself. Drains that meter as Foxy doesn't want Yamini stacking up meter to extend combos with the Hurricane Bow or those meter burn slides.
These projectiles are doing a really good job actually working out very much for Yamini as he takes another life bar.
1% arrow god that Yamini is, making great usage of all of his tools. I mean, this guy's a
nice
great arrow player
two.
From top to bottom. Plus frames. Here's the anti-air. Dustin, the combo you love to see.
Yeah, dude, it's such a cool conversion. It may not be his most optimal, I don't know Green Arrow that well, but it is the coolest looking combo.
So here we go, back to the wall. We saw what happened when Yamini got Foxy in the corner the first time, but hold this barrage of bullish, Foxy says, as he tries to deny Yamini.
Oh, this is all extra life.
Great block from Foxy. That was a meter bird. Four arrows came from that quiver, and Foxy blocked all of them.
Yeah, and that was a lot of extra life he was taking off of... off of Foxy there before his life bar got taken out. But that's the adaptation we're noticing. He's doing Hurricane Bow without burning the meter, so his hitbox doesn't extend forward.
And there's the challenge. No meter to break this back three into the forward three. Unclashable, but Foxy with the wake up. Again, one hit. The 1% arrow, not enough to get the job done.
But the
second, we're not used to seeing young Oliver Queen taking it to the contract killer himself.
It is 2-0 for Yamini. Wow, that was a lot of gunshots in that juggle. Well done getting an early start by Foxy. But we've seen Yamini melt those life leads before.
Yes. Trick shot coming in now. Foxy mixing it up with the bullets. Well, Yamini forces his way in with the meter burn roll. Overhead, low, and the staggers are clean and efficient as a Foxy Grandpa does exactly what he wants to do in that situation. Break Yamini's defense, put him in the corner, and remain full screen the entire yard of the Asylum at his disposal.
Just holding on to those arrows again, like you said, we're rocking. He will use those 1% arrows.
Yeah, man. You remember the Injustice 1 days? Yo, 1%.
Yeah.
They will forever be 1% in my heart.
Oh, and that's going to cost... It did cost a meter. That's a bar. Fortunately, though, he still has 3 bars of meter to work with. He's slowly getting in, but he's paying with quite a bit of his hit points.
And a punish on that meter burn roll. Foxy was ready for the approach. Not this time, my guy, as you get pushed back to full screen. Yamini has some comebacks in this event so far, but this one looking ever more unlikely
this one
with each passing second.
Unbelievably impressive, and at this point, I don't even know if it's possible. Yeah, there it is. Quick shot. So really good adaptation. Begin.
Jumps in, goes for the low and the overhead. Nice blocks. Both men fighting for that first bar of meter. And Yamini with that hop overhead.
Oh, nice jump in from Foxy. Gonna confirm it's 254 while setting him full screen. Now more chip. Mini with one ice arrow loaded. The trade good thing about the ice arrow, even if it's blocked, is it gives him time to move in a little bit.
Yeah, well, right there. Loads up the fire arrows instead, looking for the knockdown to help himself advance in. There you go, a dash into the meter burn and roll. But again, Foxy showing you Mini he will not walk in this building with the meter burn roll.
Yeah, I think Foxy has done a really good job of stuffing that option, and maybe Yamini could potentially come in a little more patient, but overall, Foxy is doing much better in the last game and in this current game.
Yeah, patience is Foxy's middle name, and what a read.
Speaking of trick shot.
Headshot ricocheting from the ground. Foxy getting a little fancy here. Another punish, even though it wasn't intended, on the meter burn roll. Yamini struggling to find his way in.
Beautiful landing recovery punish.
Man, I chunked that one.
Eat lead, sucker.
Green arrow coming with his quick little slick quips. And Deadshot's
Oliver
just
Queen
like,
is lead, actually kind of hilarious.
Yeah, but Deadshot doesn't care. Just eat lead. What's up? And Yamini is now in. Can he get a sequence going? He does. Over three combo into the corner we go. If he can open up Foxy
with
once more.
Bench.
And this is going to be it, pending the completion of this combo.
That's
a
it.
Foxy Grandpa now has Yamini. Cooker, Yamini in the same situation he was again with Slayer. How is it going to go? 2-2?
Okay, first hit gets the bar. And that's the one thing that I think Foxy has done a much better job of after the first two games is challenging Yamini as soon as he comes in with a back one or another button.
And this time the meter burn roll is going to get pushed back, but enough to stay in range. There's the slide. Foxy caught walking back. And meter burn rolls out successfully.
Oh, no. He still got the glove.
He did. Looking for that big chunk. Expends another bar on that meter burn slide. There's the arrows. Chasing the back jump down.
Trade. Mid screen is going to be another meter burn. He's not going to die quite yet, but the quick shot will do it.
Yeah, Foxy simply biding his time, knowing that in a chip damage situation, Yamini is trying to force his way in. Anti-air with that quick shot, and Foxy Grandpa in major control here in this decisive game 5.
Okay, and the patience again. Man, he adjusted so well, but there is an adjustment coming from Yamini. Finally choosing the burn meter a little short. Getting a little desperate now. That
and
bench is going to explode.
How unfortunate when you finally get to your opponent. He has an interactable, unblockable escape at his disposal. Yamini trying his best now. Here he comes. those 1%. Tip nice. Arrows. There's the side switch. Great air escape from Foxy in the air-to-air.
And he has to break. This is the only chance. Helmet. Both players without any meter at all. It's going to be a tie.
Yeah, clean reset here, but Foxy an advantage as they get pushed back full screen from each other. There's the slide. Yamini has to go for the reads now. The overhead.
Okay.
Into the jump three, and here we go back to the wall. Foxy, however, now has access to a clash. Yamini with the jump in. He's going to need to mix and mix well. Foxy with the excellent defense. Push block. Tries to keep everything going, and the wake up, and Foxy escapes.
Gets out. Wait, no, but he's right back in there. This is a chance. Holding the arrow a little long, and the interrupt.
Chip. And commits
just
to
like
the knee.
That.
The dream has been killed. Foxy Grandpa the
going home. Begin. Well, actually, one of these, I think, is staying for BS Fighting, so they're staying in Europe, but you get what I'm saying.
It's okay. I do. And the back two, crowning Batman right on top of his head. However, King letting the trait fly, so small trade there, but Dragon does get the advantage of gaining the bar meter from the first hit.
Nice jump, but still taking all of that damage because of the Water of Life.
And the wake up, trying to rush a move, I'm sure is not the last time we've seen it. And before I could even complete my
yeah,
sentence, here it is a third time. Slowing down, playing the patient game, checking him with the tentacle strike. Patience, walking his way in. And right after the try to rush, down one, try to rush. Here's some more try to rush. What's up? How are you feeling, Bruce? Take these pokes.
And this should just about do it. Yeah, down one. Even.
Yeah, and the smart stuff. You see Forever King noticing that Dragon traits up, immediately canceling his strength into that meter burn Batarang to gain the damage that he would necessarily get in the combo on block. As Aquaman's trait allows him to slip out of combos, but still take all of the intended damage.
Right. What's interesting about this matchup specifically, not even really these two players, but this was a matchup that was considered in Injustice 1 almost unwinnable for Batman. And now in Injustice 2, some people actually favor it, even before the nerf to Aquaman, some people favored it in Batman's favor. So that just shows how much the matchups have changed from the first game to this one.
All right, great sequence of blocks here from Dragon. Able to hold it down, not be opened up by King. Batman's so impressive once he gets in. But this time it works successfully. Challenging now, doesn't want to take any more unnecessary damage. Here's the try to rush. And that chip.
Oh, beautiful. Armored forward 3, but it is going to get clashed immediately, as that would have been a good chunk of damage.
Try to rush again as Dragon expends his last bar of meter. Keeping the chip. Gains the bar during that block string. Uses it immediately. Taking King's life down piece by piece. Here are the blocks. Great defense. King trying his hardest to open Dragon up. Not happening so far. Blocks everywhere. Look at this defense from Dragon.
Throughout all that defense, he got pushed all the way to the corner. But even still, he has the life lead.
Here's a trade now. Hefty bit of chip from that tentacle strike. The down two. Will he get the conversion? Yes, he will.
And there is no meter left on the side of Batman. And that is going to do it.
The wake up slide. Dragon simply looking for.
Begin.
The unblockable, interactable King not ready. Simply eating it. And there's a special from Batman.
Yeah.
Once you have those bats active, able to get a combo conversion after a slide. And again, great adaptation from Dragon already to the patch. Didn't expend the meter on that tentacle strike.
Just
simply
to
took
say,
the damage he could get from that situation.
Okay, here we go though. Speaking of damage, King gonna get a good bit of it. Oh, but he didn't blow it up.
Yeah, execution error there. Wanted to plant the bomb on that computer in the corner. But Dragon, no execution errors here on the Trident Rush as he mashes forward, chipping away at Bruce Wayne's health piece by piece. There should be a billion holes in the cape right now, but there are not.
I mean, that's some special reinforcement we're talking about.
This is true.
the crowd here is fantastic.
Of course, the old Shades of Injustice 1 screaming at the Triton Rush every single time. King with the plus frames. Forward three. Still plus all around. Dragon blocking.
Oh, here we go. Opens him up just a little bit. Oh, gets right over, and that's going to chip him out.
So close was Dragon. A little too early. Out of the range, Batman able to evade that tentacle strike.
And okay, there's wow, the jump just in. Chasing him down with two jump ins. Goes for the scoop to get some damage in there. Doesn't work out.
And again, Dragon just chipping away at King's health. Not much in the vicinity of full combos. Not even once.
Wow, look at this defense from Dragon.
And right on cue, he gets opened up. But that fantastic trait, the Water of Life. King continuing the combo, getting himself punished.
That was going to be the new B&B that we're about to see, but it was broken by Forever King. He wanted none of it.
Charging up that 4-3, a bit of a tease there is Dragon. King now back on the offensive, trying to open him up without the trait active. Long cooldown recovery on the Water of Life. King trying to have its way, but Dragon finds an opening. Here's the Trident Rush.
Down one again. He doesn't He wants to get the explosion off of that console, but he's just not getting it.
And now trades a bar for a bar. Dragon, no meter. He's going to have to do this straight up the old-fashioned way. No Trident Rush chip is going to help. King cutting that combo short, knowing the trait was coming. And here's a conversion.
Yep. Aquaman still does have available to a clash, but I mean, with that little life, he may not get a chance to.
Right, one piece of meter separates the spin, the scoop, the conversion, and the slam.
Is.
The
Dragon.
Power.
Begin.
And such a demoralizing situation.
Oh, that was actually kind of neat.
You have to hold that slide knowing full well you should punish it. It's like negative 200. But when you have the bats to cover your advance, why not?
Good damage here. And he is going to get the unblockable this time. That's exactly what he wanted. He could, in fact, even go for another one here. Oh, and he just goes for the kill.
Yeah, spins the bar, the optimal stuff. King coming out of the gate, firing this time. And great avoidance from Dragon. Had he blocked those bats, he would have been locked in place to eat the unblockable barrel. But now, instead, we get the B&B, 331 damage. Still very respectable for one bar.
I mean, it's not the 450 you used to get, right? But it's still good damage. Plus, you also have to realize the tools that the character still retains.
And Dragon taking the full damage from that back three. And the Trident Rush juggle. Wake up. Up by
that
the ring.
Fast. Submit, Bruce. Don't bet on it.
Walking forward. And that's kind of what we've seen from King. He's tried to... He slowly kind of walked Dragon down in order to get a lot of his offense going. Trying to save his mechanical bats for the most part, but...
Checks him.
Yeah, he is eating errant tentacle strikes and other little attacks here or there.
And Dragon, no patience, no waiting. He spins the meter as soon as he gets it, trying to rush like candy every single time. King now with the massive life lead, plus frames. Does it meet a burn it? Lands on it. Very unfortunate for Dragon. Anti-aired by the projectile. No clash. And King was looking for the trait
there.
Yeah,
he was. One bar apiece clashing. Like you said, not available for Dragon. So the next hit that King land could potentially kill him, even through Water of Life.
Back-to-back Trident rushes. Dragon now has no meter. Checks him with the down one. King traits up. Covers his approach. And Dragon with the interruption before King can let the bat go. Very close situation there.
Oh, wow.
Trident toss right to the face.
Back 1, 2, 3. That is not as plus as it used to be. And there it is. Yep, a kill right through the water. Maybe. We said we're going to stay away, but clearly UKB have decided to throw away.
There's the tire. Blocks. Batman wishes it was unblockable, but the gadget characters have to hold the utility. That's it. And denial of that slide as the Trident comes down from the skies, right into that armor.
It has been so hard for Forever King to open up Dragon. His defense is incredible. And I like the pokes and the little checks here that Dragon is also doing, even with the mechanical bats out. Well, that's kind of how you have to play against Batman sometimes. You have to, again.
Yeah, and King just wasting the momentum, and Dragon immediately is like, you know what? Get this interactable out of here.
Yeah, I don't even want this thing here.
Yeah, looking for the neutral jump pressure on Wake Up, with Dragon reacting with that anti air. Here's a Trident Rush again, chipping away slowly but surely. King's backdashing anything on block. Here's a meter burn on the Trident Rush, enough for the kill.
Who needs a Kraken?
Piece by piece, so much chip. Slow approach.
Nice. Evades the 4-2.
More chip damage, Trident Rush, and Dragon is just completely content with this. He doesn't need to open up King. He doesn't need a combo at all from this point.
No, he doesn't, and that's what I'm saying. That's what we were talking about earlier. That's why Aquaman is still a really good character. He doesn't need to do 450 damage.
He doesn't need to walk King down. He has the life lead. He can simply hang back and get this chip because the approach is just impossible right now for King.
Oh, but he just wakes up with a Trident Rush.
You cannot escape my Trident, good man.
Okay, nice. Using the mechanical bat to anti-air and then follows it up with a jump too. But still, King is very close. 400 and less than 300, excuse me. Or 300 exactly life away from being eliminated from this tournament. You know, actually, what we haven't seen at all from King was grabs. I think maybe if he had mixed in some grabs, he could have used mix-ups to a greater effect, but finally getting a tag, but again, Water of Life.
Man, this one is all but over here. No clash from King. Just going to lay it down. And
begin.
All right, here we go. Down near the Rock of Eternity. And Foxy getting chances as soon as the clock starts here in the crowd. Puts the bomb on the unblockable. Doesn't want to deal with the interactables. This early in the match, both men jockeying for position, looking for that first hit. And Foxy gets it and spins the beater as soon as he does.
Okay. We actually haven't seen a push block yet from Foxy, which is really surprising.
Afraid to challenge. There's the low pokes now. Foxy trying to mix well.
Nice neutral jump.
Theo with the perfect reach. So much recovery on throws in this game. You're able, if you bait it out, and challenges the cancel. Back to about the throws. If you bait out a throw, you can punish it with just about anything in the game.
Yeah, rather minus on pip.
Meter burn rolls out as
Very
Foxy.
Smart.
Walking back piece by piece, doesn't have to shoot bullets. Waiting for the right time. And both of these men, precious in their spacing, pressing minimal buttons, and now Theo finds an opening. Here's the forward three. To the corner we go, big time Superman punch.
A beautiful patience from Theo. That is going to do it. Jumps up, nicely done.
Please, don't get up.
Shots, and Superman blocking him with his fist, because why not? Here's the quick shot now. The low into the overhead. Theo respecting the stagger. Here's the throw from Foxy back to the corner.
Theo has no problem walking forward. He will do this all day.
Piece by piece. I can tell you, slow and steady has won the race so far. And with that forward dash, the forward two right after it, a Foxy
that
grandpa.
That was beautiful.
Yeah, he's sick of Theo. Oh my god, and the down two on Wake Up, backflips right back into position somehow, jumps out of that knee.
That's a meter con.
And Foxy fighting so much to get this last pixel, and finally finds it as Superman whiffs his string. A lot of recovery on whiff as well.
And that was a great scram. Listen, as mad as I am at Foxy for what he did to you, Mini, he's still an incredibly talented player, and he's very good.
That's really bothering you, isn't it?
No, no, it's honestly not. I've always enjoyed watching Foxy. Just not in that one specific matchup.
US.
Only one bar here, 15%, but the relief of not getting powered by Superman as Foxy commits to the overhead, makes up and drops the combo off of the wall bounce.
I gotta say, man, Deadshot for Foxy, it's an interesting pick because we've never really seen him play zoners, but it works so well.
Burn rolls, this time a bit more offensive here. Overhead mix-up staggers, trying to walk Theo steady to the corner and gets
good air to air. Now he's forced to clash out of Theo.
And no bar from Foxy, just going to allow Theo to regain his health and try to take what meter this man has left. What a bully is Foxy. Now no, basically no meter for Theo. And that heat zap that could have spelled death. Massive chip.
Oh, that trick shot was huge.
And Foxy putting it together slowly. I don't know if he has enough left in him, but Theo testing his approach. That quick shot denying all laser startup. And Foxy,
there it is. Theo taking the first game.
Yeah, a little too high on that air gun shot. That bullet sailing right over Superman's head. And that was the latest throw reaction I've ever seen, especially from a man who I've seen take more throws than just about anybody in my life. Gives away 500.
And plus the interactable, for good measure, the unblockable. Nice down two.
Catches the back dash, tests them with the quick shot, staggers.
Which aren't as real as they used to be. But even still, that's just how patient and how much respect Theo will show to an opponent.
Doesn't caught by any mix-ups or gimmicks, just playing it slow right now. Great whiff and setup from both men.
Nice.
And the air is right before the background bounce is Theo expanding two bars. And right here at this mid-range game, it's a bit different now. Theo with the dash and into the forward two, but Foxy looking extremely comfortable right here in this section. Nice punish. Theo looking for the forward two, but got his buttons reversed on the meter burn roll from a Foxy grandpa. And this looks like an entirely different matchup so far, right at this range.
I'm getting caught with the button. Back 1-2 doesn't go straight into the full combo.
Does not. Was probably looking for the background bounce, but moved Theo right out of range.
And there it is. Quick shot.
He's found the spacing that's allowed him to control that. Once he got there, the life bar basically went in his favor completely. Theo hasn't been able to get anything going from just inside of full range.
Dodging under these quick shots, trying to get back in. The life lead is not that significant anymore as Theo closes it out, but the adaptation from Foxy has been great. Like you said, he's playing at that pocket range very well as he just gets jumped in on.
Yeah, doesn't commit to it. Wasn't expecting that jump in to the land in the round right before. After the 4-3, Theo not going with the transition, electing to keep Foxy in this level back to the wall, but with the meter burn roll, here's the escape. Foxy showing fantastic usage of when to use that meter burn roll.
Theo is now, this is actually the first time I think I've really seen Theo get impatient. He's kind of dashing in when he shouldn't, uncharacteristically jumping when he shouldn't.
And that's a testament to what adaptation really means. Foxy changing his game plan from full screen to just inside of that range has not allowed Theo to do what he wants to do with lasers, with the zoning, with stopping. Foxy's approach, he has him right in that pocket area where Deadshot shining in this matchup. You can see Foxy even moving forward on occasion now. Gets a little too close with the quick shot, and Theo, with the great reactionary player that he is.
Oh, and what a beautiful call out by Foxy.
Oh, tries to interrupt. Has the right idea, but that laser pulling Theo's hitbox back. Deadshot with quick limbs, but not the reach he would like.
And I gotta say, look at the life. It was a pretty decent life lead for Foxy G, and now it may just be over already.
And that was a clutch air escape. He is still alive somehow. Theo trying to bait some different movement to get the laser on Foxy to block for chip purposes.
Oh my God, this
and
is Foxy, so close.
Again, the same situation.
Dominant, but Theo very quickly turned that lead all the way around. And was able to take the life bar. He kind of snuck it. He snuck the life bar away because it looked like Foxy was in control the whole time.
And Foxy again whiffing that 4-3 off the background bounce. They want to try to. Not entirely sure what the setup or the timing is there. But now Theo in control to the corner we go. No amount of spacing is going to help Foxy from this.
Grab throws him in the corner. Now nice whiff punish.
Yeah, and a gift.
Oh, but a drop. Again, another drop.
Third time's a charm, maybe? It is.
It is.
Foxy completes this combo. Look, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth, right? You had a combo, you dropped it. Then he woke up, gave you a free chance. If you blow it the third time,
yeah,
you deserve to
get
bopped.
Drax Bull is in play.
Unnecessary, though. Here's the background bounce with the back three, and Theo going for the max
and
damage.
He's going to get another interact. Oh, no, he actually isn't going to go for the unblockable. And that is going to do it.
Yes, plus 10, I believe, on those meter burn lasers. Now, you can't interrupt in between the gap. A fantastic backdash, getting out of the range of that string. A punish of Theo, a clash from Foxy, and now...
It's actually a cool dead shot, Mass. It's the first time I've heard this skill on it. As Theo just tags it right in the chin.
Not sure what Foxy was looking for in that situation, but now he's inching ever so close to death. Theo with the forward two pressure now. Uh-oh, and a change of pace, and Theo
immediate clash.
Now, Foxy has the meter lead here. Will he decide to take damage and make it hurt?
I don't know if he would want to spend... Oh, wow, he does. He spends two, and he's getting a 25% damage. Theo spends none.
And there's the background. Interactable usage to the corner we go, and right in the same health situation now.
This is just about dead
series.
Even.
Right in the area where he wants to be. Theo dives in, and Foxy whips the string.
That is it. Theo is going to 3-0 a Foxy Grandpa. Two in a single trade, which is kind of crazy.
Well, what else is kind of crazy is the hitbox on Captain Cold down 2, denying
that
all
is actually
from
crazy,
the air.
Yeah.
And Sonic Fox going to drop the combo for the sake of getting to level 2. He's going to have faith in his defense. All he needs is one hit and an opening, but White Boy the same. Spins a bar for a bar. Sonic Fox push blocking after that plus 6. And here it is, the plus. The level 2 snow cone. And White Boy able to evade.
He's still kind of in it, but he's backing off now. And he is going to be able
Trades
to charge
up
here.
Yep. And looking for the glitch, but just outside of the range. Misses his opportunity.
That cold, that ice cold looks so cool on this
stage
specifically.
Oh, and White Boy is in big trouble right now. And Sonic, just like that, in the midst of standing in the slow go, loads up another one.
Oh, nice teleport, but right back into a dolphin dive.
Oh, that's so cute. You took so much time, your combo didn't even connect. And White Boy looking to kill himself in this situation. Sonic Fox with the air-to-air jump kick.
Not bad. And again, he's going to be able to charge here. Backs up, and now he's on the other side of it as he's just trying to teleport desperately.
All right, has a full active traumatized now, that meter training. That full screen ground pound leading to a crumple at White Boy's disposal. Uses it, nice block from Sonic, and here comes the snow globe. White Boy trying his best to escape. Easy chase down on the back dash from Sonic Fox, and White Boy is forced to clash.
Wow, this is... not exactly actually how I expected this matchup to go down, and I forgot about that glitch completely.
Well, here's the trade from White Boy looking for it, going for the forward three instead.
That is actually very punishable.
Yeah, trying to get baited out.
And a freeze. He is going to use the icicle for this. Ooh, but the fear gas.
Yes, just enough to stay alive. He was facing a massive setup there. And the 4-3 White Boy will take exactly what he can get. Those long-range normals of Scarecrow. The wake-up.
Nice block, and this is going to spell a lot of trouble for White Boy. Oh, and what a read.
Dives right back into a cold death.
But yes, you are right. Sonic Fox is up now 1-0 against White Boy. Going to take this time to charge. Combo's going to fall.
And again, these gadget characters loving the interactables and Injustice 2. Those unblockable bombs seemingly everywhere. This is going to be a punish. Sonic not able to keep him within the snow globe, but White Boy in trouble.
And actually, that was not a lot of damage that Sonic got off of that snow globe, but now he has to fully charge it yet again.
keeps himself safe. Here's the trait activation, the 4-3 from White Boy, back to back. And three bombs, three successful unblockable hits for Captain Cold, and the bulk of that life bar.
So ridiculously fast. Yeah,
when you lose like over half of your life to interactables.
Oh! Fox was trying to run away from his problems. Dr. Crane said, no thank you. The session is going to stay.
And wow, great escape from White Boy. That jump sickle as the trade is activated, looking for the 4-3 punish. Sonic Fox charging his gun at will. And this is so hard. Meter burn rolls out.
Oh, but he gets out.
The smart stuff from White Boy. Using a bit of his resources, but jumps into it a little too preemptively.
Dolphin dive yet again right into that puddle.
And Sonic Fox, so smart, backdashing and pulling the screen in his direction.
Four weeks ago, you and I would not even be having this conversation because no one would be playing the character. Or if the character was on screen, we would think it was a joke.
Nothing funny about this level 2 snow globe.
No,
but Sonic Fox lets it rock now. White Boy fighting his way out, but that command grab not going to connect. Sonic Fox in hit stun from the down 1. Runs back into his home. And great meter burn back 3. Stopping Sonic's approach now. 2 bars on this restand. Hold this fear toxin in your face.
That is a lot of damage. 558.
More plus frame. Sonic Fox waiting it out. Great anti-air again. That down 2. Such utility. Great punish there on that ice puddle. White Boy biding his time now. He is the one in control.
Yes.
That damage over time from the Scarecrow trait and doesn't mean a thing if you can't make an approach. The snow globe, also known as the stop signs of life. White Boy not able to advance within 10 feet of Sonic in the past 20 seconds.
Yes, actually looking, it was looking good at first for White Boy, but he does get a 4-3. Get setting up.
All right, White Boy trades up once more closer. But again, here comes the exit strategy. That snow globe breaking off all of the space in between these two competitors. And here it is. Sonic just simply charging it up and looping this. What is White Boy going to do?
What can he actually do in this situation? Somebody, he can't really go in because he's not going to get there fast enough.
There's the trait. Here's the level 2 as White Boy makes his approach, and now he may have pulled the screen a little too far. Traumatized is blocked successfully. Dolphin dives into
it. He tries it, he gets in.
And with the desperation shrink, it works, and now White Boy is in there. He's going to get the completion of the combo, stretching those legs out. Take him to the Gotham Gym, stretching Cold out as well. In the corner, pressure and escape in between the gap is Sonic Fox. Right back to a snowy death? Yes.
Nice. Blocks from White Boy. He does manage to fight himself out of the corner and out of that dangerous situation, but
and
still.
So smart from White Boy. The push block into the meter burn roll. Trait is active. What will he do? Looks for the 4-3 this time. Sonic Fox charging it up at level 2 again. There's the 4-3 trade. White Boy is going to actually try to advance forward.
The suspense
it's so hard to watch because White Boy is trying so desperately to get in, but he's not able to. With 3 bars available, he is going to win the clash. But he still has to deal with this character.
And the trade is up. Sonic Fox losing his health. Oh no, Traumatize is active. Here comes the mix-ups. Wake up now.
Good block.
Jumps in. Here's the chain looking for Chip in any situation.
Oh, and there it is. The double projectile.
Meter burn gunshot. And
the architecture, the landscape, everything here is great.
I agree. Oh, you're going to see a lot of patience in this one as Dragon throws the TVs.
Oh, man. I just realized what I'm getting myself into.
Looking for the shimmy there is Theo. Maybe Dragon challenges with the down one. Walking just out of the range, trying to bait Dragon into fighting back as Black Adam, clearly not a fan of music, tosses the jukebox. I'm not sure was playing in the streets of Metropolis, but they don't listen to it in Kanda.
No, they don't.
When dive kicks are playing everywhere, no matter where Black Adam is, doesn't quite get the combo conversion as the bounce was a little weird, but Dragon's going to spin the bar meter here on that Black Magic, which has less combo scaling after the fact. 383 damage, still extremely healthy.
Very good.
And in a pixel situation, Black Adam trades the win
button. He is one of the best. But we're seeing Dragon clip Theo after that forward 1-2-3 breath with a forward 1-2 of his own. And that was a problem, actually, in the first Injustice that Black Adam couldn't deal with.
And great cancel there. 4-1 into the tray. Theo looking to block the rest of it. It's opened up for the throw. With punish with the down one into the lightning hands. Great blocks from Theo. But again, even better blocks from Dragon.
Nice backdash. Still going to have to block that standing three, though. Or not standing three, excuse me. The 3 of 4-2-3.
Famous last one.
Again, backdashing so that he doesn't take the 4-2. Nice armor back 3.
Yeah.
Going to get very good damage here off of trade over 400.
Add additional chip in there, and the nice reaction from Dragon waiting for the air escape. Now Theo trying to figure it out desperately. Nothing going, and I mean nothing.
Nothing is going.
All chip damage. 4-2-3 breath loops. Dragon not in a rush to end this match at all. Built some meter here on the defensive side. Another throw from Theo, but again, it's going to need 20 more of those.
Oh, wait a second. Dragon thought he was home free with that trait, but Theo
did get the damage. Now that trait will be active here after this sequence. Trait is back. Here it is, the activation. Theo trying to stay out of the range, but the meter burn roll.
Oh, and he lands right on it.
What are you going to do? Begin. All right, game two. Dragon starts with the jump in now. Theo challenging the plus frames. Easy hit confirm here. 4-3. Jump kick, dive kick. To the ground you go. That spark of lightning coming from the gods above.
He looks so majestic after 4-1-2 grab. Like, he just lays it out. Yeah.
Big chunk of chip there from the heat zap. But it's going to need more than that. Take a risk trying to toss Steve around, and Black Adam is clearly friends of Steve, punishing Theo for his actions.
There's the trade. Oh, one globe remains.
Just trying to dash in at this point, looking for any.
Yeah, and Dragon, I mean, he doesn't care. Whatever. If the globe run out, he'll get in.
Looking
dash
for the
forward and 4-2-3. Still working with the first life bar. Theo, double grab. I like that he's now incorporating these grabs, because that's gonna open up a lot of mix-ups later if we can condition Dragon in that way.
Yeah, and Dragon clearly okay with giving up the grab, not looking to tech on a read, and maybe he's a little late on the reactions, but at that point you can wait for the trait to come back, simply wake up with it and get the kill.
Also want a back three because that would trigger a stage transition here.
And this is enough for Chip. No,
oh,
Dragon
no.
knows. And goes for the dive kick immediately. Theo ready with the defense. Quick punish now into the corner. Dragon trying to force his way out with that forward one. Trade is active. Theo backs off.
I mean, this is where generally Theo wants his opponent, but Dragon has been just such a puzzle to open up for Theo that I don't think it matters as much that he has him in the corner.
Yeah, well, you saw right there in that sequence, he put together one of the pieces with that shimmy on the down one into the 4-2, forcing Dragon to clash now. And another call out on the wreath. Theo pressing the right buttons at the right time. Dragon with the answer. Such defense coming from both of these guys.
Nice block and a beautiful punish.
You're an opportunist.
Yeah, we're looking at a situation where Dragon was in super for depth. Both guys spinning the extreme 4 bars, full amount of meter. He's going to rely on things the old-fashioned way until one of them builds
him. Grab from Dragon. Yeah, you're right. Good blocks. Theo has some of the most experience against Black Adam, I think, over anyone in the world, and that spans 2 games. But even still, Dragon is actually kind of making it look not easy, but pretty convincing.
4-2-3 trade.
Nice breath, air to air.
And does he have enough left in the tank to kill? He will not trade up just yet. Now he does. Any chip situations? And a clutch tech from Dragon and
down
a dash up anti-air.
And that is going to do it. Wow. He actually had eyes on the punish in time.
Yeah, excellent call out. Dragon dashing forward and simply reacting. Seeing that Theo went for the jump back, and Black Adam underrated down to win this game. That quick punch that has such a massive hit region.
His down is actually really good.
and back right at you. Shimmy. This time, Theo in prime position. The wake-up button from Dragon get punished by a perfect media attack right on point.
And a neutral jump straight into it.
A different type of read. Pushing buttons didn't work. How about a jump?
Ooh, and that was an attempt to potentially cross him up in the corner. It didn't work, as now Dragon finds himself with a 4-2 in his face and a life bar gone with Theo, the first real lead he's had in this set.
Comes the combo. Dragon wakes up, down one into the trait, continues the pressure, but Theo blocks it all. Chip damage at this time. Dragon's going to challenge the trait cancel.
Nice, he's going to confirm, and that, never mind.
He may have had something else in mind there. Whatever the situation was, he wasn't able to complete the combo, and now Theo just gaining more mileage from this life bar, Dragon in big time trouble.
Blood in your place.
Clash comes out. One bar per player, they're both going to spend.
And again, that black magic, not enough. Theo chip damage now, everything adding up. There's the trait. Looking to gain a hit, and Dragon staying solid. However, down to only a little over 300 health points.
Theo just desperately trying to get these down ones.
Looking to take the throw with Dragon, but yeah. Theo was just out of range. Jumping around the skies now, punish on that whip like magic, and Theo chip damage away from victory here in this game three, trying to stay alive. There's
nice
a dive
jump.
Kick.
And that is going to do it. So Theo finding himself again.
His voice being pumped through my audio. I'm not sure what that was.
Got a very interesting and conscious there.
Kind of weird, honestly. As we start game three, Dragon on the losing end so far. There you
nice.
Go.
Wait, beautiful score. Confirm off of that down two.
Yeah, Theo was looking for the anti-air in the first place, so tried to bait it out, and then Dragon simply waited on it. But man, a raw back three to start off a trait combo.
Damage.
And right back at you, screams Dragon. Will this be enough to kill? It is not. However, the chip damage? No. Theo back in control, trying to take the life bar down at the same time. And a bait on the throw. This time, Dragon takes it. And eats the laser to the face. No trait for you, sir.
Yep, and that is going to be Theo sticking with a little bit of life he still has left in the first life bar, making all this damage essentially free. Doesn't have to worry about paying with his life because that was his life.
Yeah, great chase down there. Dragon saw that Theo back there is trying to escape this certain death, and he says, "No, sir, I am coming with these orbs, and you are going to hold these."
Nice whip punish, beautiful backdash from Theo.
I'm Conduct's king.
Ooh. Not anymore.
Ooh, okay, so clearly Superman is gonna dethrone this once king of Conduct.
Nice back to trade. Good down one challenge, chasing down the backdash, but that was a huge mistake.
Dash up now, Theo getting hyper aggressive, even towards the corner now. Shimmying, trying to force Dragon into a mistake, keeping it safe now. Trait is active. Theo with block, still on the offensive.
And rolling out is not even going to help him here, as he was in the
begin.
Very interesting.
That time, Dragon doesn't go into deep contemplation or consult with his own brain. Rematches immediately, now 2-2. The aggression is up, both traits trying to bait out a throw attempt, and Theo is going to get the first full combo here. And gets the meter on the activation of that breath. Such a great system that meter burn is. Able to see a move and then confirm it by pressing the meter burn after. Fantastic design.
I actually really like that, I think, over the MK system for MKX, but I mean, that's just cool. It's also because I'm bad, I'm old, so my reactions are terrible. Good damage here, but it was a mauling in the beginning for Theo as he chips him out, and he did that. That was very smart.
And now Theo is in control on the cusp of completing the reverse 3-0. There's the whiff black magic dragon. Somehow able to escape back. Down one, checks him into the throw. The pound on the Black Adam's chest, looking for the same mix-up. However, Dragon ready with the blocks. And Theo just blocking that entire sequence of pressure, but not the raw jumping. This should be enough to kill Dragon with the completion, and it is going down to the last life bar. 2-2. Theo's back to the wall, but more meter in his possession.
Oof, what a trade.
And trade's definitely not in Dragon's favor in this situation. Those huge chunks of life coming from the lasers, but on the startup is Dragon with that meter burn dive kick. Into the corner we go. One sequence away from oppression. Dragon with the plush frames, keeping this sequence going.
Nice meter burn back three, and another one. Look at all that damage.
So smart with Theo. Too early on the tech.
Oh, the forward one gets him right under.
And Theo was unable to clavish here with such a huge meter deficit. Dragon in control. Too early with the dive kick once again. Dashes up. Looks for the string and the super.
Oh, no, he can air dash. He can. And a block still.
Still survives. Here comes the trade. The down one and the throw from Dragon. The final chance. Under one HP left. What is going to be the call? The
down two. And a clash.
This is unreal. These guys have no meter. It's going to reset at neutral. Anything is going to do it. Superman's trade is active. Chases.
Oh, my
and
goodness.
The down two.
Dragon. Come out just barely on top.
All right, well, here we go. Losers finals. White boy against Dragon in the run back. And denial of exit, sir. You will stay in this corner and love it as Dragon defies authority with that EX dive kick saying, no, white boy, I will move as I please.
Oh, nice. Tries to go for the wake up.
Hey, stretch and stretch and pull.
And one and two.
We need the command grab to finish it off. It's all good. But this time a punish on the regular. No meter burn and Dragon with the awareness to know white boy was trying to get away with a little dirt there. Plus frames.
Wow, look at all of this. Still working with that life bar as Dragon.
What a fantastic
He is
sequence.
The king of the small pixels here.
And right back at you is Scarecrow, the secondary king of it. That big sickle covering the vertical space in front of him as Dragon tries to dive kick his way in.
Look at that. Just kind of walks up, pokes, backs off.
Yeah, and the push block, white boy enforcing his will. Dragon's had enough, however. Doesn't want to deal with it. Armor's through.
Oh, it actually just goes right over him. Is that a nice block on the ambiguous neutral jump two? Still gets tagged by low lightning.
And it's all picking up now. Scarecrow trying to figure it out. White boy sitting on full meter. And looking for any opening. There it is. Jump three into the command grab. Dolphin dive. Push blocks immediately. Dragon's like, forget
Smart.
Your plus frames.
Smart push block by Dragon. And oh, and a last second clash.
Absolutely.
Three bars for white boy. One for Dragon.
And you knew exactly what white boy was doing there. A wake up forward dash when someone's in your face. You're trying to force them to hit you in a combo sequence to get for the clash. Luckily, in his favor, Dragon gifted it to
and
him.
That was a beautiful sequence. Dragon to the loser's bracket.
White boy.
It's starting that way now, but never count Dragon out. If there's one thing I've learned.
You know, not only do we have a gym in Gotham, we play marbles down in Atlantis. Black Adam, not the greatest sport as he keeps the first unblockable, but avoids the second one. Dolphin dives back in. Here's the loop.
He was trying to chase the backdash there.
Gets the jump in too, and again, that conversion into the raw command grab. You're looking to block as Scarecrow has good damage. An amazing corner carry. Caught in the loop. The mind game so efficient from white boy right now.
And that is, wow, what a dominant life lead.
Great anti-air. You made note of that forward one earlier.
It's really good, man. For an anti-air, it's one of the best normal buttons besides just like general down twos.
And every time that Dragon takes
it. Oh, and he just gets errantly hit.
If you notice, every time Dragon takes it to the air, so does White Boy. In all reaction, he will do his jumping attacks.
And that's the thing that makes this matchup so daunting for Black Adam, right? Is the fact that whenever he jumps, the normals that are available to Scarecrow in the air are just better than, well, not necessarily better, they just have better range.
Absolutely. And the boot stomp and the chest plant right now is Dragon.
Yeah, that was nice.
Who has shown being down any amount of games or any amount of life has no bearing on his playstyle or his ability to win. It's gonna get the clash.
I'm immune to your trickery.
Yeah, and also another thing to note about what I just said about the normals being longer reaching, Dive Kick has no priority, and it'll trade or even get beat out by most air normals. Teleports in. Dragon is slowly killing himself with that fear toxin that's surrounding him, and he has to back off.
Trying to find his way out
there
in that chain.
2-0. Two games.
Well, recovery or not, that voice in his ear has told him to return to Atlantis. Picking Aquaman here is going to be locked in for the next potential three games. But White Boy on the offensive beats him with the air-to-air, and Dragon trying to slow it down.
Yep, but I mean, the last time we did see White Boy go up against an Aquaman, it did not fare well for that Aquaman.
All right, the big Gator Slap. He currently has no fear as he's just a dead animal hanging in the background. Trident Rush and great reaction from Dragon there. The meter burn back three to match White Boy's spike into the corner. 430 damage and Aquaman.
Still here, in there.
Here to ruin your day.
Yeah. Oh, wait a second.
Competence is scary.
Full screen now, walking back and forth. Has a threat of the Tentacle Strike, so White Boy doesn't kind of move freely around the stage like he once he did. But once he has gotten in, the Wake Up Trident Rush denied twice
now. That is really actually hard to stuff. So Trident Rush is not an invincible Wake Up, but it has a very tight timing in which you can stuff it. And that's the first time all weekend we've actually seen it.
Another thing Trident Rush does amazingly is break armor. So many hits so fast as White Boy try to meter burn back three there. Dragon with the denial with the Trident Rush now. Chip damage territory. White Boy looking for plus frames. Spends all of his meter.
This is so close. And that is going to be a small punish.
Plus push blocks away and the roll forward three.
That's a punish. Wait, no, he misses it.
And challenges back. Here's the Trident Rush. He doesn't build a beater in time. Back dash.
And what a reaching normal in the air. That is going to do it. White Boy. Netherrealm is not done with this game in the slightest. And their support, as well as Warner Brothers' support for our scene, has been nothing short of amazing.
That's true. They should definitely buff Wonder Woman. I agree. So
yeah,
right into the Joker's playground.
Do they buff Firestorm too then while they're at it?
Uh-huh. We were talking about NRS and their support in the tournament's world. I'm not sure what Firestorm had to do with any of this.
Actually.
All right, well, the level 2 trade is out. Wasn't sure if that was a button check or not. These guys actually going crazy. And the denial on the escape from the interactable is White Boy. And Cold putting up that wall does not want Scarecrow in his space.
So the one thing I would say right now, White Boy is doing a really good job of getting in on Sonic Fox, but...
Oh, goals for the
4-3.
Yes. Yeah. And the side switch.
And he's actually just going to go for the kill. He's not going to go to charge his trait. But what I was going to say is, what exactly can White Boy do in this matchup? Because last time, Fox made it look hopeless.
All right, now into the corner, exactly where you don't want to be. Keeps it ambiguous with the massive... hitbox on that Wake Up Fear Gas.
Charging every little second that he can while backing up. He's going to get caught. Not the biggest of punishes there. And now setting up the puddle so that he can do the charging of his trait. He's going to get it out, and there it is. This is exactly where we saw trouble for White Boy. He was able to almost do nothing in the last set as he teleports in, and there's another Snow Globe ready.
And great teleport there from White Boy. He would have had his back to the wall as he dunks Sonic Fox with that big sickle 4-3. Unfortunately, he dashes right into an unblockable with 1, 2, and 3.
Oh, no. Trips slightly on the yoga pad.
Yeah, I'm kind of tight. Captain Cold has not renewed his membership at the Gotham Gym, so Scarecrow refused to teach him. That's all that happened. It wasn't a drop combo in the slightest.
Ooh, Jackie's trying to charge, and I will say the adaptations here made by White Boy are pretty solid. He's using whatever long-range normals he can, but this is really bad.
And again, Sonic Fox able to recharge it directly to level 2. This is the wall that he put up in the last set, and White Boy teleports into the corner out of desperation.
And that Dap 2 is going to catch, yeah, absolutely. And look at all of this damage, almost about to kill. Nice block, and that's the punish.
Yeah, great juggle there. Extended slowdown from the globe, allowing him to get multiple walls in that combo of the meterless variety. Sonic 5 goes up the first game here in Grand Finals.
Down 2 is so ridiculous, man.
Plus frames now. Sonic Fox calling out the command grab with the neutral jump punch. White boy trading in between that 6 frame down 1. Only -2 from Scarecrow. So much mileage. Can go into the command grab for it, into the sickle, into another one. So many mind games from a poke. And white boy being the most effective, clearly.
Yep, but here comes the frozen land. Oh, and that was so slick.
Straights up. There it is. Full traumatized. And looking for the landing punish. Unfortunately, can't find it. Will we get it traumatized? We do. Keeps him grounded for the plus frame. Sonic Fox caught. Disrespecting.
Very nice from White Boy.
Taking advantage. In the wake up wall. Here's. Yeah, White Boy says, I can go around the back. That's okay with me. And not this time. Sonic puts it right on his dome. There's the level 2. Block, hit, stun right into it. No juggle there.
Nice backdash. Still stubborn. White Boy is trying to get in there. Yep.
Stretch. Taking his time. Blocks the ice puddle. And one. Captain Cold is a terrible student, man. He just doesn't want to learn how to participate in the exercises. Sonic Fox clashes.
Some people say he's stiff because he's a cold man. No? Okay. I'm saying, like, usually, like, you're rigid when you're really cold. You know what? Never mind.
And they're jumping with punish now. White Boy on the defensive has the clash himself. Now this is going to reset. Sonic Fox's tray hasn't been able to charge after that last successful snow globe. He's going to be back to the wall.
This is a good situation here for White Boy. He can really make something happen here.
And the push block now gets the snow globe out and the down 2. Oh man, this could be trouble for White Boy.
Oh, a beautiful with punish. And push block again. Down two, you can't jump.
And can he kill from this juggle? Here's a death sickle. Double overheads and White Boy challenging. Get the plus frames.
Gets it.
And success file. And he knows what time it is. 1-1. However,
I think
White Boy,
actually the first game he's taken against Sonic Fox, though, in this tournament.
Great backdash. But again, White Boy with the perfect normal jumping in. This is going to be a full combo punish. And this time, no meter burn on the sickle swing.
I gotta say, the adaptations that are being made here for White Boy, using a lot more 4-3s and using whatever he can to get in on Sonic Fox, is very impressive.
Absolutely, waking up with that wall. The down 2 trying to deny Sonic if he was looking for a jump, and now we are in chip territory. The dash up, Captain Cole cannot take this damage over time.
Wow,
1-2-3
right back
and four
in there.
And 5. And back to the business. This man doesn't want to work out. He just wants to sit in his cold. The heat a little bit too much. Disrespecting the Florida boy is Snart. Doesn't like our climate or the weather, but instead, to the corner we go. Sonic Fox not blocking.
Oh, never mind.
Misses the traumatized link, but White Boy, ultimate pressure right now. What side did that hit
that
on?
That is going to do it. Wow, 2-1. Yeah, White Boy has adapted, and a smile from Sonic Fox saying, all right, I see you.
But this is definitely very serious. Now White Boy does have to reset the bracket and keep it going. The unblockable interactable. No whiff punish a little too far. Fear gas. Let's go as we march towards the corner.
He is going to spend the time to charge. There is 2. He's going to break the armor because of how slow he already was, plus the snow globe.
And drops the combo intentionally to recharge his gun at level 2. So much strategy involved here, and White Boy's going to have a hard time getting out of this one.
And he is going to use the backer. He's going to spend the meter to kill with the puddle.
Yeah, when that snow globe of death is out on the screen, you panic so hard because you're going to die over time and or freeze. All Sonic has to do is simply react to your actions and punish you for a full combo anyway. Now plus frames, this is guaranteed chip damage. And
very
just
nice.
Like that, White Boy, 1 health bar away from the reset.
Oh, just runs right into it. That was smart, but also very disrespectful.
Yeah, White Boys falls for it. That sweep, pushing Scarecrow's hitbox a little too close. Granting Sonic a freeze as Captain Cold goes to recharge his gun once again.
Nice, jumps over the unblockable. Oh, you wanted it so bad. I was willing to do it with you there, too.
That sounds terrifying.
Oh,
wow, okay.
Really unfortunate situation there. White Boy trying to walk up and block it. However, getting frozen in a huge momentum shift here in this fourth game is now Sonic Fox's full screen with charge. Icicle death coming from both sides and chip damage galore.
Oh, and that is unfortunate. He actually didn't get the he dropped the combo. Game tied up here, 2-2.
This is now tournament point for Sonic Fox. White Boy, does he have anything left in the tank to push this to another set in Game 5? Sonic Fox with the first attempt at Devastation to the corner, spins the bar on the meter, and actually continues the combo this time.
Oh, and that is so dirty. Captain Cold is disgusting in the corner, and that's going to hit. Wow, and look at this, a flawless first life bar for young Sonic Fox.
Level 2 active, one bar meter forward combo, and great denial of that interactable usage with that max range forward 3. White Boy plus frames. And trying to stay in front is White Boy, but he's in big time trouble. Evades the freeze somehow.
Nice backdash, but even still, White Boy is going to get the hit, but this is still very rough for him.
And a full combo now. Sonic Fox going to keep it unclashable. Wake up, Fear Blast. That entry denied. White Boy again trying to inch forward. Successfully does it this time. And there's the Death Sickle. No punish.
And this is it. This is so very close. Is Sonic Fox going to win Vianality? All he needs is this, and that is it. He is your winner.
Icy Death awaits Scarecrow, and the toxin stops right before it can reach the Fox's Den as Captain Cold takes the first premiere after the latest balance patch.
Yep, it is Sonic Fox, your 2017 Vianality champion with Captain Cold.
Unreal as we get Storm to the stage.